Gildan Media, a division of Recorded Books, presents Entrepreneur Voices on Growth Hacking by the staff of Entrepreneur Media Incorporated, edited by Derek Lewis, foreword by Sean Buck, narrated by Steve Menasche and Marguerite Gavin. Foreword by Sean Buck. Growth Hacker, thenewsletterpro.com. Have you ever wondered what the secret sauce is behind some of the fastest-growing, most successful companies in the world? Why are we now seeing companies start up and grow to $1 million, $10 million, or $100 million in sales in record time? What is causing this phenomenon? Oftentimes, this crazy growth is attributed to the internet. While it's obvious that the internet has played a role as a platform that has allowed companies to provide unique services and improve quality of life, the internet wasn't the driving force behind the crazy growth of these companies. Like with any company, you don't open your physical or virtual doors and all of a sudden floods of customers flock to your business, money in hand. No, this modern-day gold rush was created by a new breed of marketers. These marketers are not simply college grads with a marketing degree looking to create the next Fortune 500 company's branded billboard. In fact, these marketers aren't even accurately described as marketers, but instead as growth hackers. Growth hackers are a new breed of marketers who are hyper-focused on finding new, innovative, and widely successful ways to grow a company faster at increasingly lower CAC, customer acquisition costs. Growth hackers aren't only found in large internet unicorns. At my company, The Newsletter Pro, we've used growth hacking techniques and strategies to take an offline print newsletter business, yes, you heard that correctly, from a startup to one of the fastest-growing privately held companies in America. Our growth of 2,975% in the first 3 years was followed by another 1,100% jump the following year. And it wasn't an accident. It was hacked. At The Newsletter Pro, we experienced crazy growth because we used growth hacking techniques and were laser-focused on getting new customers, creating success for them, and driving referrals and our overall revenue as fast as we could. In order to do that, we couldn't rely on traditional marketing to get us there. If this is the speed of growth that sounds fun to you, you're in the right place. As you devour this book, I want you to pay close attention because you're in for a wild ride. You're going to get to hear from some of the very best growth hackers in the world. Because of the uniqueness of this subject, a large number of crazy smart growth hackers have contributed to this book to make sure you can see the latest and greatest ideas, techniques, and home runs that growth hackers are using today to scale companies at lightning-fast speeds. Frankly, you're not going to find a better collection of content on the subject anywhere else. That said, I have one final thought, and it is about you. The fact that you're listening to this book tells me something about you. It tells me that you too have this feeling that right now, the way marketing is being taught and executed in most companies is not the way of the future. The old and many times outdated techniques you learn in school or that are used by even the largest companies are not going to help you quickly grow your company. It is obvious you're not interested in the slow growth grind of business from our parents' generation. You know the grind I'm talking about. The kind that takes years to turn a profit and you're happy with 10% or maybe even 15% year-over-year growth. No, that's not for us. The fact that you're listening to this book tells me that you're ready to take the leap into a type of business development that is fun and exciting, the type that is going to allow you to experiment with out-of-the-box techniques to find new ways to grow at speeds unimaginable a few years ago that turns dreams into reality. If I'm right about you and why you bought this book, then welcome to the club, because you, too, are a growth hacker. Preface. Not your average hacking advice. The word hacking gets a bad rap. To hack something is to break it, essentially. To hack is to cut, to slice, to chop away, sometimes using very irregular methods of doing so. By hacking, you are breaking something down and cutting away at the excess of it. As associated with computers, hacking means to modify or break into a system or software, often with nefarious intent. Growth hacking, however, is an altogether different kind of hack. Instead of cutting away at something in the physical world, like that annoying hedge in your backyard, you are cutting away at what keeps your business from moving forward. Like a stealthy computer hacker, you are modifying your current system in a new, clever, and often unconventional ways. Growth hacking is all about stripping away the excess of your business and focusing on reinventing the very nature of growth at lightning speed. It's about flipping the script and finding new ways to move ahead of your growth projections and your competition. A relatively new concept, growth hacking is finally coming into its own and is one of our most read-about topics at Entrepreneur. From harnessing the power of chaos or scaling up at lightning speed to redefining your content marketing strategy or disrupting your local business landscape, our contributors are covering tons of new ground on growth hacking. In this book, our team of writers helps you navigate the ever-changing world of growth hacking, from how to invest in your growth potential to harnessing the power of out-of-the-box marketing strategies to elevate your brand quickly. You are going to hear about disrupting the marketing process, orchestrating company expansion, hiring expert growth hackers, customizing the sales process, and even amping up your relationship skills, all to achieve growth at the speed of light. You see, this book isn't about how to copy the vibe of some cool tech startup. We focus on the things that matter. Proven growth techniques and approaches that result in not just swift and sustainable growth, but also in quantifiable longevity for your business that will last generations. After all, what's the point of exponential growth if you don't have a long-term plan to go with it? Our contributors know that, as do the people they look to for the latest in growth hacking advice, from design titans Chip and Joanna Gaines to rap mogul Soldier Boy. All agree, it doesn't matter where you do business or what product or service you sell. It just matters that you take each opportunity for scaling up and find a way to reinvent it for the long haul. So be that hacker. Chip away at what your business doesn't need. Find a way to come to your plans for expansion in new and unique ways. Hack away at old methods, outdated expansion plans, and passé talking points to create the growth trajectory that will take your business where it needs to be. Let's get started. Part 1. A Crash Course on Growth Hacking. What is growth hacking? It's hard to pin down, but to paraphrase Supreme Court Justice Stewart, I know it when I see it. In this book, you're going to hear differing definitions of growth hacking. Some are just a matter of semantics. Some are fundamentally different. Some authors talk about the different ways to hack your company's growth. Some are more concerned that you know why you want to do so in the first place. In fact, some even offer conflicting advice. And that's the beauty of this book. Instead of tips and tricks from a single author, this little gem offers advice from dozens of perspectives. An accelerator mentor, a cookie dough entrepreneur, SaaS experts, and more. Instead of trying to find common ground, we have found great content on the topic and brought it all together in one place. Here in part one, you'll find a cross-section of expert advice on growth hacking, from trying to define it to trying to do it. You'll find entrepreneurs who love the idea and those who abhor the phrase itself. Enjoy your ringside seat. Chapter 1. Growth Hacking is All in Your Head, by Andrew Metal. For companies looking to grow, a solid growth hacker can easily be mistaken for a superhero. With new channels through social media, video, and content popping up all the time, hacking growth has become a more complicated process than it was a few years ago. The game has gotten harder, but the rewards have also gotten bigger. If you have a knack for marketing and love making things go viral, there's never been a better time to become a growth hacker. To help give you a better understanding of what it takes to be a true growth hacker, here's what you need to get you started. 1. A feel for the audience. The internet is packed with options that help improve conversion rates and build loyal followings. From social media pages, advertising platforms, and emails, as a hacker, you have plenty of ways to cultivate a community of customers. It's your job to discover which customer segment is the most viable for your business and how you can find a way for that segment's involvement with your company to go viral. Get started by having a feel for your audience and your ideal buyer personas. This understanding will be a good place to start, especially as you work to find out which channels your core customers will most likely be found on. Segment your audience into 3 to 6 different personas based on who you want to target first and who you want to put on the back burner. Remember, one of the easiest ways to hack growth is to master the marketing funnel of a small niche group, then replicate it. If you look at most tech companies that have gone viral, Facebook, Uber, Airbnb, they all follow that same mentality to some degree. This will allow you to dissect the groups most inclined to your brand. A deeper insight into customers' interests, values, and occupations will help you tailor your message directly to them, making it much easier to get conversions. 2. A measurement obsession. Today, marketers use analytics tools because they have to. Simply put, if you aren't analytics-driven, you aren't a real growth hacker. Data-driven marketing tools encourage not only growth hackers, but the entire organization to plan ahead and think about their results and goals in defined, measurable metrics. Without measurement tools, marketers quickly fall victim to making decisions based on vanity metrics. Planning ahead and using solid data and management tools will help you decide which metrics are right and allow you to take action faster, smarter, and more effectively. It'll also improve the output of your team and give very clear definitions of the deliverables and goals you need to hit. But before you go on a marketing tool buffet, it's important that you spend most of your time understanding what the right data is for your measurement model. To start, identify your business objectives, your goals for your objectives, your key performance indicators for each goal, and finally, the segment audience for each objective. The mindset behind gathering this information stems from a need to keep a focus on business goals as opposed to just one aspect of your business, like your website. As your site grows, the allure of vanity metrics can lead you away from the reason behind building your site in the first place. Your best approach to staying up to date on all of these important aspects is keeping an equal eye on your entire marketing funnel, and then pinpointing which part of the funnel is the bottleneck to going viral for your company. 3. A mind for data-driven decisions. The number one thing on every growth hacker's mind has to always be metrics. As a hacker, you will have to make decisions backed by hard data. The old fogies of the marketing world dodge necessary analytic tools and make decisions based on gut feelings. They overlook the fact that in today's ever-changing digital age, gut feelings don't accurately reflect the actual moving parts behind your business's performance. They rely on what they see instead of what is actually happening. On the contrary, good growth hackers understand that data-driven information will lead to a true understanding of the effectiveness of their spending. The best growth marketers understand that the best decisions and projects ride on the support of solid data. Always have hard data to back your decisions. Start by becoming a pro at Google Analytics and work your way into new platforms from there. Growth hacking in reality is more a mentality than an actual skill set. If you're obsessed with growth and a bit of a data nerd, you're already well on your way to becoming a true growth hacker. Chapter 2. 5 Growth Hacking Myths for Software Entrepreneurs by Matthew Capala. Growth hacking has become a popular buzzword used by many people who often know a fair amount about growth, but usually very little about hacking. Certain misunderstandings and even myths have become attached to the term. These common myths are problematic because they conflate, confuse, and practically destroy the proper meaning of growth hacking altogether. Here are 5 you should be especially wary of. 1. There is a growth blueprint. There is no ultimate blueprint, roadmap, template, checklist, or rulebook to growth hacking. While examples such as Airbnb, Uber, Dropbox, etc. provide nice case studies to list in blog posts, more often than not, successful growth hacking strategies and tactics work once and only once. The good news, however, is that there's no shortage of growth hacking best practices. You can discover them by perusing articles posted in the growth hacking section of entrepreneur.com, over at growthhackers.com, or via a gaggle of recent books on the subject. Bottom line, growth hacking is as much about attitude, curiosity, playfulness, and empiricism, and capability, willingness to code and to get one's hands dirty, experiment, fail, adapt, and reiterate, as it is about replicating the methods already used in specific instances. 2. They will come just because you built it. While it's not theoretically impossible for a great software startup to go from zero to infinity on the basis of its organic marketing efforts alone, the odds of this happening materially diminish each day as the massive user platforms, I'm looking at you, Facebook, continue to constrict organic reach in order to attain their own growth metrics. In the early days of the web, it was much easier to build scale, to rank on the front page of Google, or just to stand out in the feed. Today, do you really expect your world-ruling app to stand out in the App Store without some kind of marketing push? Or to dominate Google by outsourcing your SEO? I don't think so. My point here isn't that attempting to build products with built-in users isn't obsolete. But unless you've got some kind of marketing budget in place to strategically push your product, you'll be running handicapped in a very competitive race. Remember, you're competing with a wily group of growth hackers. 3. Great products sell themselves. This myth is likely an unwanted, unconscious byproduct of the feature-obsessed engineering focus of so many software startups today. Yes, we know your code is beautiful, but even the best, most innately viral software needs to be discovered. Otherwise, the dream of deploying a perpetual motion conversion machine will remain in your head. Discovering what will make you discoverable means digging into your data. The uglier it is, the more likely that it will yield insights. Resources include 1. Website analytics, Google Analytics, 2. Email open and click rates, MailChimp, AWeber, 3. Social and content marketing, Buffer, BuzzSumo, 4. SEO, SEMrush, Moz Open Site Explorer, Yoast, and 5. Heat maps, feedback polls, surveys, user session recording, Hotjar, Qualaroo, InspectAlert, Clicktail. Measure this data, analyze what's working, and then optimize. Repeat as necessary. 4. Growth hacking isn't black hat. Black hat refers to aggressive, often underhanded SEO strategies. Yet, just because your strategies and tactics are incomprehensible to your standard Wharton-educated CMO, that doesn't make them disreputably black hat. If there's anything truly black hat and flat-out illegal, it's the way Madison Avenue agencies habitually, allegedly, use media rebates from big brand budgets to line their own pockets. Sure, growth hacking often means using legal loopholes, Uber, reverse engineering, SEO, algorithmically generated anti-competitive tactics, Google, and other tactics that may or may not be entirely ethical, but these tactics are part and parcel of the envelope-pushing hacker ethos, which doesn't wait for a tactic to be validated by the establishment before it's deployed. 5. It's all about acquiring new users. Fred Wilson, a veteran New York-based VC who knows a thing or two about startup culture, Wilson's firm survived the dot-com bust of 2000 very nicely, notes that too many businesses these days are stepping on the gas before they find a proven product-market fit. Instead, Wilson suggests that a company focus on your 90-day retention numbers and make sure to nail them and prove you have a product-market fit. Then scale. Growth hackers know that existing users are always the best place to look for new users. Uber's strategy reflects this stance perfectly. It's all about personal referrals, word of mouth, and unpaid referrals. Put another way, leaky buckets don't need more water, they need their holes fixed. This means that a lot of growth hacking isn't that radical or revolutionary. It's about paying attention to what your best customers want, then giving them more so they'll serve as trusted, reliable PR mouthpieces. Do the work. Andrew Chen, one of the first to really define growth hacking, suggests that action and experimentation lie at the essence of the term. Unless you're actively probing, testing, learning, optimizing, and failing, you're just talking the talk. Chen put it nicely in a Reddit Ask Me Anything session. People, he wrote, are getting all their knowledge about growth from reading blogs rather than actually doing the work, running the experiments, and building great products. I couldn't have said it better. Chapter 3. The Entrepreneur's Guide to Hiring a Kick-Ass Growth Hacker by Neil Patel. So you've heard of growth hacking and you want it. If you're an entrepreneur, you'd be crazy not to want it. Growth hacking? Heck yes, I'll order 3 of those, please. Unfortunately, growth hacking is often misunderstood. The word growth is undeniably positive, and hack is a buzzword. But what we're left with is an emotionally appealing word without a whole lot of substance. So how do you hire a growth hacking ninja who will skyrocket your startup to the top? Understand what it is and is not. To wrap our heads around the concept, here is the definition from Wikipedia. Growth hacking is a marketing technique developed by technology startups which use creativity, analytical thinking, and social metrics to sell products and gain exposure. In other words, it's in marketing where you are free to color outside the lines. Gone are the marketing conventions of Mad Men. Replacing the old approaches are a slew of social media-oriented and internet-powered techniques combined with other mystical ingredients that together make up today's digital marketing milieu. Yes, growth hacking is all of that and more, but don't let techniques throw you off. Growth hacking isn't all technique. Growth hacking is a mindset, a way of approaching the whole idea of marketing. Sean Ellis, the man who coined the term, defined it as a person whose true north is growth. That definition says nothing about techniques. That's why I want to emphasize growth hacking as a mindset, a focus rather than a set of systems. Growth hacking requires outside-the-box thinking, skepticism toward conventional marketing methods, plus the ability to pivot and adapt to new situations. So, how exactly do you find the perfect person who possesses all of these characteristics? Look for a strategist, not a technician. You want to find someone who is a master of strategy rather than actual technical implementation. Let me illustrate. One growth hacking technique is split testing, a method of conducting controlled experiments to improve a website. You could do one of two things. One, hire a conversion optimizer who is skilled at split testing. Or two, hire a growth hacker who tells you to do split testing, but who may not personally be able to do it. See the difference? The growth hacker knows that you need split testing in order to have a website that is optimized for conversions. The conversion optimizer knows how to do the split testing and how to implement the winning variation. Strategists can pull together all the different pieces of marketing and growth, synthesizing them into a powerful force that allows you to grow at a ridiculous rate. They may not know the nitty-gritty of every piece, but they recognize the importance of every piece and how they work together. Don't look for a growth hacker. Here's a classic rookie mistake. An entrepreneur wants a growth hacker. They prance off to Craigslist or LinkedIn to find one. But hold up a sec. Remember, growth hacking is a mindset. It's not a job description. It's an approach to marketing. If someone calls themselves a growth hacker, they may or may not indeed be a growth hacker. In some cases, they may completely misunderstand growth hacking altogether. Rather than look for a growth hacker, seek out a really good marketer who possesses a growth hacking focus. Find someone who's done it before. The best growth hackers are those who have hacked growth before. This should be obvious. Unfortunately, it's easy to get swept up in the hype, the verbiage, and the visions of exploding growth. When that happens, you can overlook the basic qualifying feature of the growth hacker. Have they done it before? Sean Ellis became the consummate growth hacker of Silicon Valley when he discovered the power of disruptive marketing. He was able to think beyond techniques to truly analyze the characteristic aspects of a business. And he got results. He didn't have a playbook he could hand off to a marketing guy. Instead, he created systems and processes that could be scaled and maintained to channel torrents of growth into a business. Can you hire Sean Ellis? Yes, kind of. But the more important thing is to find someone who has a few notches in their marketing belt, innovative approaches to marketing that have produced bottom-line results. Become a growth hacker yourself and hire specialists. One of the most direct routes to finding a kick-ass growth hacker is to be one. How, you ask? At this point, it's become a mantra in this article, but I will reiterate it. Growth hacking is a mindset. It's not a set of sexy techniques. It's not a method. In fact, growth hacking can get wild and out of control. Why? Because it's a mindset. Growth hacking is fueled by an insatiable desire to grow, come hell or high water. Growth hacking stops at nothing to achieve the goal of growth. Growth hacking rests on trial and error, sometimes to the point of losing touch with reality. But that's kind of the whole point. Growth hacking doesn't come with a how-to guide. Growth hacking feeds off innovation. So here's how to begin your personal transformation into a growth hacker. Understand marketing at a foundational level. I'm not talking about methods. I'm talking about the entire approach of marketing. You must know your customers and your market and understand data. Discover what's working. Become familiar with growth hacking techniques that have worked for other startups. Read about the growth sagas of Airbnb, Dropbox, and Uber to learn how they did it. And innovate, create, test. You'll find your greatest successes come from just trying stuff. As Sean Ellis wrote, since most growth ideas fail, it becomes critical to test a lot of them. The faster you can hack together an idea, the sooner you can start testing it for some signs of life. Conclusion. The minute you think you understand growth hacking is the minute you forget what it is. Don't worry, you're in good company. Growth hacking is an elusive concept. Nobody owns a definition. Just as there's no single correct definition, so is there no single right profile for the ideal growth hacker. There are no lists of qualifications, years of experience, or types of software a growth hacker needs to know. You'll know your growth hacker when you meet them. They'll be wild-eyed, talking about growth, and passionate about innovation. They will be experienced in the art and ready to make a positive impact on your business. Chapter 4. To grow a business, expect some chaos. By Andrew Leonard. Dan Lewis has been wrestling with one of the most common and critical bottlenecks that bedevil every tech startup seeking to scale fast. How can his company staff up quickly enough to cope with expected growth without blowing through cash unsustainably? Lewis is the CEO and co-founder of Convoy, an on-demand trucking startup headquartered in Seattle. So the first idea he had felt obvious. He should open up a second office in a city that's way cheaper than Seattle. But he just wasn't sure, which is why on a Friday evening in early March, he'd trekked down to Silicon Valley to meet a man known to have answers to quandaries like this, Reid Hoffman. The two men sit down at the Sand Hill Road offices of Greylock Partners. Greylock, where Hoffman is a partner, led a round of financing for Convoy in early 2016. Hoffman now sits on the company's board. "So, what shall we talk about today?" he asks. "Customers or recruiting?" "Recruiting," Lewis answers. Lewis dives into the details of his problem, and Hoffman settles into a posture that looks well used. He steeples his hands in front of his chin, fingertips almost touching his lips, elbows splayed sharply to the left and right. His eyes might be half closed, but his body language is benevolent. He could not possibly be more attentive. And when Lewis is done, Hoffman has plenty to say. If Convoy does pursue a second office, they'd better make sure direct flights are available from the new city back to Seattle. Requiring execs to regularly make multiple-stop cross-country journeys plays hell with company culture. It's a minor point, but one you might never think of unless you'd been there yourself. But splitting up corporate teams may be premature, Hoffman adds. It runs the risk of disrupting the learning loop, that all-important, constantly iterating process in which a startup figures out how best to do whatever it's doing by observing itself in action and making the necessary course adjustments. Lewis nods. You can see him writing those words down in his mind. The learning loop. This, after all, is the effect Hoffman has on people. It's why the 49-year-old billionaire, co-founder of LinkedIn, veteran of PayPal, and venture capitalist, is widely considered something of a seer in Silicon Valley who can distill complex ideas down to important truisms. For founders wrestling with big, sticky questions about their company's promise and direction, a few words from Hoffman can go a long way. A conversation can go even further. That's why Lewis and his co-founder chose Greylock as their lead investor. Reid can go into the weeds and say, here's how to think of an onboarding experience for a product. Here's how to think of a marketplace. Here's how to think of a recruiting growth strategy, Lewis says later. Another beneficiary of Hoffman's capital and wisdom, Kiva president Premal Shah, concurs. Reid gets into the foxhole with you. But for Hoffman, getting into weeds and foxholes isn't just about helping the individuals he's invested in. It's about something greater, something that, he hopes, will push all entrepreneurs.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.